For 25 years, students from across the Granite State have come together to match wits with their peers. The competition can be fierce, but so can the fun. Even so, the stakes are high because only one team can win. The Granite State Challenge. Now, here's your host, Jim Janot.
And thank you very much. Hi again, everybody. Welcome to another game of Granite State Challenge. Two new teams ready to go to battle tonight. This is our 12th game of our 16 opening round contest. 11 high schools have already won games to move on into our second round. The winner will also join them in our second round of competition. Before we do start our game, I'd like to just give you a reminder to visit our website where you can register and sign up as an alum of Granite State Challenge. We'd love to hear from you. And at the same time, you can view and download any of the programs from this year or from last season. You can do that on YouTube or through the iTunes Music Store. So check it out on the webpage. All right, let's take a look at the teams playing in tonight's opening round game. First of all, we have the team from Pembroke Academy, enrolling about 1,060 students, located in New Hampshire's Merrimack County.
Hi, I'm Stephanie Jones, and I'm a senior.
Hi, I'm Lindsay Crete, and I'm a senior.
Hi, I'm Stephanie Allen, and I'm a senior.
Hi, I'm John Ardini, and I'm a senior.
The team is coached by Michael Natalizio. His alternates are Neil Inarelli and John Natalizio, the Spartans of the Pembroke Academy. So that's our first team playing tonight. Let's introduce you to their opponents. They come to us from Portsmouth High School, enrolling about 1,055 students located in our state's Rockingham County.
Hi, I'm Elizabeth Harvey and I'm a junior.
Hi, I'm Garrett Rose and I'm a junior.
Hi, I'm Linnea Kay and I'm a junior.
Hi, I'm Max Esposito and I'm a junior.
Also with us tonight, the coaches for the team, Hannah Duell and Brendan Harrington. The alternates are Andrew Harvey and Aaron Hayes, the Clippers of Portsmouth High School. And our last introduction is to let you know who our judges are. And this week they are Ann Belanger and Mary Riley Potter. And they are our judges. We thank them for their help. Here we go into round number one. It's a 10-point toss-up round. We'll get into our bonus and 60-second rounds a little bit later. But right now, Pembroke Academy and Portsmouth, 10-pointers. Good luck. Here we go. Give the nationality that precedes all of the following. Checkers, junk, puzzle, wall. John of Pembroke Academy.
Wall.
Portsmouth. What we were looking for was the nationality that precedes any of those, and we were looking for Chinese, as in Chinese checkers, Chinese wall, etc. Here we go for 10 points. Identify the word for a claim on the property of another until a debt has been paid. Lindsay of Pembroke Academy.
Lien.
A lien is right for 10 points. Identify either the device known as an ornithopter or the 16th century Italian who has seen in his drawings deduce some of the principles of aerodynamics. Elizabeth of Portsmouth.
Leonardo da Vinci.
Leonardo da Vinci. And the device we were looking for was aircraft. Either one we would have taken, correct for 10 points. Paper and pencil is found in front of you if you think you might need it. What is the perimeter of a square if the area of the square is 81 square meters? John of Pembroke Academy.
36 meters.
36 meters, well done. Here we go for 10 points. Identify the first Roman emperor. The eighth month of our calendar is named for him. Linnea of Portsmouth.
Augustus Caesar.
Judges, are you going to give, did she spill it out enough? Augustus is correct for the 10 points. All right, here we go for another 10-pointer. Give the term for a range of the male voice higher than bass and lower than tenor. Garrett of Portsmouth.
Baritone.
Baritone is correct. Now for 10 points, which adjective, beginning with the letter J, means of or like the planet Jupiter or majestic? It comes from another name for the god Jupiter. The adjective we were looking for was Jovian. Identify the section of the colon that extends up toward the liver. Stephanie J. of Pembroke.
The pancreas?
Try Portsmouth. was the ascending colon. Another paper and pencil type question for you, teams. Find the total area of the six faces of a cube whose volume is 27 cubic inches. John of Pembroke Academy.
9 square inches.
Portsmouth. Total area of the six faces, Linnea?
54.
54 square inches is correct. Now for 10 points, who was the third U.S. vice president? Stephanie J. of Pembroke Academy.
Aaron Burr.
Aaron Burr is correct. Now for 10 points, tell me, who was the first athlete to win both the pentathlon and the decathlon in the Olympics, doing so in 1912? His name was Jim Thorpe. On June 18, 1812, Congress declared war on Britain after heated debate. What names from the animal kingdom are used for those opposing war? Stephanie J. of Pembroke Academy.
Doves.
I can repeat it for Portsmouth. On June 18, 1812, Congress declared war on Britain after heated debate. What names from the animal kingdom are used for those opposing war and those favoring it? Garrett of Portsmouth.
Doves and hawks.
Doves and hawks is correct. What colorful term is used to designate a baby born with cyanosis from a congenital heart lesion or lung defect? Lindsay of Pembroke.
Yellow.
Portsmouth. Alinea.
Blue.
That they're looking, that's the color, and that is for a blue baby. Express the square root of 108 in its simplest radical form. Max of Portsmouth.
2 root 8.
Pembroke Academy. You judges? We're looking for 6 times the square root of 3. For 10 points, which 3 amendments to the U.S. Constitution were ratified during Woodrow Wilson's presidency? The 17th, the 18th, and the 19th. Which French composer of the Romantic period wrote the piano piece Clair de Lune and the orchestral masterpiece La Mer, or the Sea? His initials are CD, Elizabeth of Portsmouth.
Debussy.
Say again?
Debussy.
Yeah, that is correct. Claude Debussy is correct. Arrhythmia, or irregularity in the rhythm of the heart's beating, played a part in the 1990 death of Hank Gathers, a college basketball player. Spell arrhythmia. Stephanie J. of Pembroke Academy.
A-R-Y-T-H-M-I-A.
Portsmouth. Alinea.
A-R-T-H-M-I-A.
Goes A-R-R-H-Y-T-H-M-I-A. Arrhythmia. Here we go for 10 points. Still in round number 1. UN scientists have announced that global warming, or try it again, U.S. scientists have announced that global warming is causing the frozen subsoil in the Arctic to melt at an alarming rate. What word beginning with P names this subsoil, Elizabeth of Portsmouth?
Permafrost.
Permafrost is correct. One more time in this round. Nope, we're not going to go with that in this round. That's the end of the round. And we got a game going where Portsmouth has taken the early lead by a score of 80-30. We'll get into that big bonus round in just a moment. Right now, we take our first time out. Going to ask Tim Estilos to join us, as he does each and every week. As he talks to the team members prior to the program, prior to today's program, he talked with the squad from Pembroke Academy.
Hey, Jim, I'm here with the team from Pembroke Academy, and Stephanie is the team captain. Now, you were in the St. Paul's program this summer. What was that all about?
Yep, I studied molecular biology, so we just spent a lot of time in the lab and learning about DNA and proteins and all that fun stuff. So definitely something I want to do in the future, so we'll see how it goes.
So she'll pursue that as a career. And you watched the Olympics this year. She's a big fan of Michael Phelps. Now, do you have his picture on your wall?
Of course I do.
And what is it about Michael Phelps you enjoy?
Well, his face, even though some people say it's smushed, and, you know, his talent, he's really, you know, skilled, so.
Yeah, fit a little swimming in there somewhere, and she also has this car called the Brown Bomb, but we'll talk about that another time. Now, Stephanie, number 2 here, you're on the varsity tennis team.
Yes, I am. This is it's gonna be my 4th year on the tennis team, and I worked my way up kind of from the bottom, and we have a great time, and all the girls really enjoy it, so it's fun to hit around at practice, and we really get along well.
You traveled to Europe as well. Where'd you go?
Yes, I did. Two summers ago, I visited six countries. We did France and England and Germany, and I actually got to spend 3 days with a German family. Mm-hmm. So I got to see all about their culture, and I went to school with them, and then I got to kind of see their perspectives on the American culture as well.
A great trip, it sounds like. Now, John over here, you do some things on Sunday. You are very involved with, what, your CCD program, I understand.
Yeah, on Sunday mornings after church, I go to CC. I help teach the third grade.
Mm-hmm. And you also are on the varsity soccer team. Tell me about that.
Yeah, I've been playing soccer ever since I was three, and this year is our senior year, and we're 5-1 so far, so it's a pretty good season.
Sounds good. Over here we have Lindsay. Lindsay, you are the yearbook editor. You play tennis. You know, what of those two things you enjoy the most?
I have to say the yearbook committee, because it's really fun getting to take pictures of everyone at school and building something so at the end of the year everybody will remember it. Mm-hmm. And so it's just kind of funny to be able to capture pictures of people doing silly things and be able to say, I did that. I took a picture of that.
And you also enjoy skiing, right?
Yeah, I do. Downhill skiing. I like to go fast down the slopes and try to avoid hitting as many people as possible.
And she also enjoys singing to the radio in her car, but who doesn't? Anyway, this is your team from Pembroke Academy.
All right, nice to have the team from Pembroke here right now, looking to make a comeback in our big bonus round, trailing by 50 after round number one. But in the bonus round, we continue to ask the 10-point toss-ups, with the team that gets the toss-up correctly gets a chance at additional bonus points. So it's a big round. Pembroke, Portsmouth, good luck. Let's go to the paper and pencil one more time to start this round. If a piece of wood weighing 12 ounces is found to have a weight of 10 ounces after drying, what fraction of the wood was moisture content? For piece of Lindsay of Pembroke Academy.
1/5.
Portsmouth, Alinea.
1/6.
1/6 is right for the 10 points. So over to Portsmouth we go. Elizabeth, you're the team captain. You can talk to everybody up there. And talk to them and choose from these categories. Mine, the eyes have it, or keep it brief. Mine, the eyes have it, or keep it brief.
We'll take the eyes have it.
The eyes have it. And Elizabeth, again, you can talk to everybody, but I take your answer for the team. 5 points apiece. Identify each of the following by giving an answer beginning with the letter I. Indian group that Spanish conquistador Francisco Pizarro conquered in Peru in 1533.
The Incas.
Correct. Product brought into a country from another country.
Import.
Correct. Electrical system that starts a car's engine.
Ignition.
15 out of 15 on the bonus. Well done. Let's go with another 10-pointer. Which U.S. cabinet department was originally created as HEW, the Department of Health, Education, and Welfare? This department is known as HHS today. Stephanie A. of Pembroke.
Health and Human Services.
Health and Human Services, right on the money. So we'll go over to Pembroke, where Stephanie J. is our captain. Talk to your teammate, Stephanie, about whether you want mine, keep it brief, or science showdown. Mine, keep it brief, or science showdown.
We'll take science showdown,
please. Let's go with the science showdown for 5 points apiece. Identify each of the following concerning science. Word designating both the bright central part of the head of a comet and the central part of an atom.
The nucleus.
Correct. What the abbreviation BTU stands for, designating the quality of heat required to raise the temperature of 1 pound of water 1 degree Fahrenheit. BTU.
Barometric temperature unit.
It is a British thermal unit. And the term designating either of two times in the year when the center of the sun crosses the celestial equator. It is the equinox. So we're going to give you 5 out of 15 on the bonus and go with another 10-point toss-up. Which word, derived from the name of his native land, identifies the type invented by Italian Aldo Manuzio that gave a slanted style to Greek letters? Stephanie A. of Pembroke Academy.
Italics.
Italics is right, and so we'll come right back to Pembroke. Stephanie, you can choose between mine, keep it brief, or flashback 2002. Mine, keep it brief, or flashback 2002.
Mine? What's mine?
We'll try mine, please.
Let's go with mine. We want you to identify each of the following by giving an answer, including a possessive. Vessel that saved human and animal life during the biblical flood, according to the book of Genesis.
Noah's Ark.
Correct. Longfellow poem about a hero who warned the colonists of the British advance toward Concord.
Paul Revere's Ride.
Correct. Name the animal and owner that allegedly started the fire that destroyed much of Chicago in 1871.
Mary Beth's cow.
Might be from the same family, but it was Mrs. O'Leary's cow, to be honest with you. Let's give you 10 out of 15 on the bonus. All right, let's go with another 10-pointer. Advertising execs say that doing work free for nonprofits keeps them visible in hard times. Which two-word Latin phrase beginning with P is used to designate such work done for free, Elizabeth of Portsmouth?
Pro bono.
Pro bono is right. So back over to the Clippers we go. For Keep It Brief, Flashback 2002 or Grammar Games? Keep It Brief, Flashback 2002 or Grammar Games?
We'll take Flashback 2002.
Let's go Flashback 2002 for 5 points apiece. Identify each of the following concerning events of 2002. Continent to which U.S. Marines were sent to step up the war on terrorism by monitoring activities in countries and waterways in and around its so-called horn.
The Horn of Africa.
Wait, continent?
Continent. Africa.
Correct. Toxic metal known as HG that a terror suspect was carrying when Russian authorities arrested him.
Mercury.
Correct. Rebellious province high in the Himalayas where China's new leader, Hu, presided over the introduction of martial law prior to his rise to party power in 1992. We're looking for the rebellious province.
Nepal.
It was Tibet. 10 out of 15 on the bonus. And there's the sound ending our round. We're halfway home. We still got a good game going with Portsmouth holding on to the lead by a score of 125 to 65. Our 60-second round is just around the corner. Before we get there, though, let's again call on Tim, this time talking with the team from Portsmouth High School.
And we're here with the team from Portsmouth High School. Elizabeth over here is the team captain. Now, Elizabeth, you play the harp. How long have you been doing that?
I've been playing for 9 years. I take lessons from Stephanie Curcio.
Mm-hmm. And what do you enjoy most about that? Because that's a really interesting instrument.
My mom played, so I just like sort of playing like she did. Mm-hmm.
And now we've got a whole group of travelers here. You went to Thailand recently.
Yeah, I went for 5 weeks. I lived outside Bangkok. I was doing scientific research at Mahidong University.
Sounds like a good time. Now Garrett over here, Garrett did some traveling as well. You went to India not too long ago for a volunteer program. What was that all about?
That's correct. My mom and I wanted a way to see the world, and we thought that'd be a good way to volunteer abroad and see some things.
Mm-hmm. And what was the most interesting thing you saw over there that you enjoyed the most?
I actually got to see elephants in Jaipur, and that was fun.
And did you try riding some of them? That's what I want to know.
No, it's actually ethically incorrect because the elephants aren't treated well in that area.
Oh, well, that's a good thing to know there. And you're also into track and field. You do some running, right?
Yes, I do the mile and the half mile.
Okay, now over here we have Linnea, and Linnea went to Turkey. What was going on in Turkey for you?
We did different homestays, which means we stayed with a family from Turkey, one in Istanbul and one in a village called Inigul. And in the village, we painted the school mm-hmm. for 2 weeks.
And you're also on the lacrosse team. How long have you been doing that? How much do you enjoy playing on the team?
I really like playing lacrosse. I've been playing since I was in eighth grade, so this will be my fourth year. Our varsity team is actually back-to-back state champions, so we're hoping to win again.
Sounds good. Now over here we have Max. Max, you're into something called skimboarding. Tell me about that real quick.
Skimboarding, it's a beach activity. It's similar to surfing, except for you throw the board and jump on. You go into the waves instead of with the wave.
And of course, keeping with the whole theme of traveling, he went to Italy, he went to Pompeii and Rome, right? Okay, let's get back to the game with this group of travelers. We're going to travel back to the studio. This is your team from Portsmouth High School.
And you look at the team from Portsmouth, and they built a little bit of a lead after round one, maintained it in round two. We come to round three, which is our 60-second round. We'll be asking each team 10 questions in 1 minute. We give them 10 points for every correct answer, and we'll bonus them 10 points if they get them all right in under a minute. So the team that trails does choose the categories first. So Pembroke Academy, you can choose from Holy Days and Holidays, Around the World, or Potpourri. Holy Days and Holidays, Around the World, or Potpourri? Stephanie?
We'll go with holy days and holidays.
Let's go with holy days and holidays. And again, Stephanie, you can talk to everybody, but I take your answer for the team answer. Identify each of the following concerning holy days and holidays. Start the clock. Holy day, marking the Jews' exodus from Egypt and the angel of death's passing over Jewish homes marked with lamb's blood.
Passover.
Correct. Holiday established in 1986 on the third Monday of January.
Martin Luther King Jr. Day.
That's correct. Name meaning Fat Tuesday, given to the New Orleans carnival season.
Mardi Gras.
Correct. President who in 1863 proclaimed the last Thursday of November as Thanksgiving Day.
Lincoln.
Correct. Date on which the French sent mock gifts to those refusing to adopt the new calendar, now a day to play jokes on people.
April Fool's Day.
Correct. March 17th, holiday honoring the
St. Patrick's Day.
Correct. Holiday the Pope set up in AD 469 to honor a Christian martyr in an effort to replace a pagan holiday for the Roman god of love.
St. Valentine's Day.
Correct. Day of the week that is the Muslim Sabbath and in Christian belief the day on which Christ was crucified.
Saturday.
It is Friday. Month whose 14th day in there's the sound. Any amount of round judges they get. So if they add up, they're going to get. They only had 8 questions, got the last one wrong. I believe it's 7 out of the 10 judges. We're going to go with 7 out of 10 on the 62nd round. So we're going to put. They're going to go with 6? I'm sorry, I back it off. 6 out of 10 on the 62nd round. 60 points onto the board. And we'll go over to Portsmouth for Around the World or Potpourri. Around the World or Potpourri?
We'll take Around the World.
Let's go Around the World. And when, again, Elizabeth, you talk to everybody. I take your answer for the team. Identify the countries headed by or formerly headed by the following leaders and known for the given features. Identify the countries. Start the clock. Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu, Negev Desert and Sea of Galilee.
Israel.
Correct. Prime Minister Tony Blair, Thames River and Westminster Abbey.
United Kingdom.
Correct. Prime Minister Jean Chrétien, Vancouver Island and Hudson's Bay.
Canada.
Correct. Premier Li Ping, Tiananmen Square and Yellow River.
China.
Correct. King Fahd, Mecca, Oasis Settlements and Oil.
Saudi Arabia.
Correct. President Hosni Mubarak, Aswan Dam and Giza.
Egypt.
Egypt.
Correct. President Jacques Chirac, Seine River, the Louvre.
France.
Correct. Chancellor Helmut Kohl, Rhine River and Frankfurters.
Germany.
Correct. President Saddam Hussein, Euphrates River. Say again.
Iraq.
Correct. King Hussein, Dead Sea, Jordan River.
Syria.
It is Jordan. And they get 9 out of 10 on their 62nd round. Well done. Nearly had our first perfect one. 90 points, though, out of the scoreboard for Portsmouth. We come to the end of round 3. They continue to maintain the lead right now, 215 to 125. All right, let's go into our fourth and final round. No more talking to each other up there, guys and girls. Pembroke and Portsmouth, 10 pointers the rest of the way. Good luck. If in botany, it refers to the natural line of splitting, as when a seed pod opens. In anatomy, it's the line at which two bones are fused together. In surgery, it's the process of sewing together tissue. What's the word? The word we were looking for was suture. Last one of this today. Paper and pencil in front of you. What is the value of x in the statement x equals the logarithm to the base 64 of 4? What is the value of x, Lindsay at Pembroke Academy?
Third.
X 3. Equals 1/3 is correct. According to legend, which Philadelphia woman, born Elizabeth Griscom, created the first Stars and Stripes flag in 1776, Stephanie J. of Pembroke?
Betsy Ross.
Betsy Ross is right. Actress Jane Alexander resigned her position in 1997 as chairwoman of the federal agency, Lindsay of Pembroke Academy?
The FBI.
Repeated for Portsmouth, actress Jane Alexander resigned her position in 1997 as chairwoman of the federal agency supporting the arts after winning the fight for funding. Which of the following designates this agency? FHA, NEA, or FAA? Max?
FAA.
It is NEA. We got about a minute to play. Identify the ology for the science of the study of man, especially the customs and social relationships of mankind, Stephanie J. of Pembroke.
Anthropology.
Anthropology is correct. In the election of 1896, what precious metal was associated with Linnea of Portsmouth? Say again.
Silver.
I can repeat it. For Pembroke in the election of 1896, what precious metal was associated with trust, Wall Street, and big business? Now, Stephanie J.
Gold.
Gold is right. On April 24th, 1800, Congress approved an act that established one of the world's greatest libraries. Name this repository, which now holds about 100 million items. Elizabeth of Portsmouth.
Library of Congress.
Library of Congress is right. What poet wrote "I Hear America Singing"? It was Walt Whitman. And just as that happens, the sound ends, ending our game. It'll be Portsmouth High School advancing into our second round with a well-played game tonight over Pembroke Academy. Got the lead in the first round and never relinquished it. Good game, though, for both teams. Hope you enjoyed it at home. We have another one coming up for you 1 week from right now. We hope you'll be watching as the team from Pelham High School meets the team from Somersworth High School. That's our program next week. Thanks for watching. Good night, everybody.